Scrapwood projects really are some of the best out there, especially when it comes to something as beautiful as this figured maple. For this project, I could have easily routed a decorative edge around the piece, but I decided a black frame would really emphasize the beauty of this figure. Since this is nothing more than a simple frame, we're going to start by milling stock a bit thicker than the figured maple and cut 45 degree miters at one end of the first two corner pieces, and then clamp them together with spring clamps. Now to mark the length and location of the miters at the opposite end of these first two pieces, I hold the stock in position and then draw a reference line on the back side. I repeat this for the other piece and then transfer the line with my square so I know exactly where to cut. With these first two done, I'll repeat the process for the remaining. To help avoid wear and tear on the figured grain, and maybe to use up some more of my scrap, I added a block that holds the keys out and away from the face. Once I cut it to length, I then chamfer the edges with my block plane to help avoid any splintering, starting first with the ends and then finishing with the long edges that are going to be proud of the surface. Before final assembly, I take the time to paint the frame and key ledge black and then apply a few coats of shellac to help pop that figured maple. The frame is then glued to the maple along the long grain, and the sides are glued at the miters along with a small dab in the middle to help accommodate any wood movement. The key ledge is fastened in place with a little glue and two screws that hold it from behind. To help attach it to the wall, I add two hangers and the final touch of the L hangers to hold the keys, which I know I'll still struggle finding at some point down the road.